There you go. Or kraut. Or mustard. Pretzels, pocket meals. We're good.
We volunteers have to pay our bills on the run.
Yes, Nora's paying bills over there.
Oh, see?
Shall I show him what I got new? Shall I show him my new attire?
And this, show them what can happen when you volunteer.
This is what happens when you volunteer.
Show them how soon you get. Yes.
You get slim, and you get breasts.
So all you ladies out there.
That's enough now, Bob. You can take your camera over to Bart and Lee, who are going to volunteer tonight.
Well, if you just put your hands down, I'm trying to get the full festival thing. There
yes,
we go.
I don't know what purple is. If purple is one of the colors that they can do, then purple might be a four-color process. It might be a two-color process or a three-color process. Purple might be two colors, red and blue. I don't know.
All right.
And basically, that's where you're at. You've got to. But if there's combinations of colors,
a lot of fun to make.
They've got to melt, and they've got to be. I understand the process and focus.
Turn off samples.
Okay. Well, that would be one way of getting samples.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
There's some. Mm-hmm.
Well, welcome back this evening to the 6th Annual Anchorage Folk Festival. And I'm not Poppy Hopkins, but I'll just pretend that I am, so if I say anything wrong, she gets all the credit. Our first performer tonight is a man that I personally am very fond of. He always warms my heart. It's George Gardner tonight, not George Sanders. He sometimes goes by that alias. But he's a Yupik Eskimo, and he's going to sing you some Irish songs, and I'm sure he'll tell you how that happened. I don't know. George Gardner.
Tonight, but it's not because of that. In 1988, my wife got to go over to Dublin to participate in the millennium there, the 1000th anniversary, and she told me that I could go to the next one. And I just found out tonight, I just realized tonight that I have a paid gig that month, so I can't do it. Far across yonder pool lies a true fairy land, with the sea rippling over the shingle and sand, where the gay honeysuckle is pouring the bee, and the green glens of Antrim are calling. Sure, if only you knew how the warmth of the moon
Soon I hope to return to my own cushioned hall. 'Tis the one place for me that can outshine them all. Sure, I know.
Show tonight. But first you have to join in with me on this next song. It's called When the Boys Come Rolling Home, and the chorus goes like this. If I can find the right key. There'll be dancing, romancing, and nevermore we'll roam. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the day, when the boys come dancing, romancing, and nevermore we'll roam. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the tay, when the boys come rolling home. Okay? You want to try it one time? There'll be dancing, romancing, and nevermore we'll roam. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the tay, when the boys come rolling home. I'm now if I can just remember the la 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 la. I always will remember well the day we went away, sailing out to Belfast in the morning. Our hopes were on tomorrow as we kissed our friends farewell, but our dreams were on the day and I'll return. And there'll be dancing, romancing, and never more we'll. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the tay, when the boys come rolling home. We safely reached the other side in New York City Fair, in spite of wind and rain and stormy weather. We all sat down and drank a glass and wished each other well, and we said we'd all come back again together. There'll be dancing, romancing, and never more. Rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the tay, when the boys come rolling home. Well, Joe, he went to Boston, and Sam to Buffalo, and Pat went out as far as California. I used to get some letters then, but that was long ago, and they always spoke of Ireland and returning. There'll be dancing, romancing, and never more we'll roam. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the day, when the boys come rolling home. I must be over 90 now, me grandson's by the bed, and here I'm in Chicago and still scheming. He says he'll take me back again to rest me weary head, and I'll leave him a legacy of dreaming. There'll be dancing, romancing, and nevermore. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the tay, when the boys come rolling home. One more time. There'll be dancing, and nevermore we'll roam. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey. here's another immigration song. This is a love song to a grandfather. It was written by an Irishman, but it applies to all of the people that have come over. How many of you are one or two generations away from being American? Yeah. Okay, this is called Immigrant Eyes. Better get the right key. A love song to a grandfather. Old Ellis Island was swarming like a scene from a costume ball, decked out in the colors of Europe and on fire with the hope of it all. There my father's own father stood huddled with the tired and hungry and scared turn of the century pilgrims bound by the dream they were standing in lines just like cattle, bolt and sorted and shoved. Some were one desk away from sweet freedom, some were torn from someone they loved. Through the sprawling Tower of Babel came a young man confused and alone, determined and bound for America, carrying everything that he owned. Sometimes when I look in my grandfather's emigrant eyes, I see that they reflected a gamble of my feelings inside. I see starting with nothing and working hard all of his life. So don't take it for granted, say grandfather's emigrant eyes. Now he sits and stares out the window, but his eyes are still clear as the day he sailed through the harbor to come ashore on the island of tears. My grandfather's days are numbered, but I won't let his memory die, for he gave me the gift of this country and the look in his emigrant eyes. Sometimes when I look in my grandfather's emigrant eyes, I see that they reflected, and I can't hold my feelings inside. I see starting with nothing and working hard all of his life. So don't take it for granted, say grandfather's emigrant eyes. Don't take it grandfathers and grandmothers. It's one that I wrote. It's one of two that I've written. I've always told Mike Campbell, who has written hundreds of songs, it ain't necessarily you don't have to be prolific, you just have to be profound. Anyway, this is called In Search of a Song. When I was a young man, I dreamed of a farmland, the call to adventure would beckon me on. I had I met on that wandering road would help me by sharing my load. The faraway places with strange colored faces still shares the same sunsets as those. forever back. I roamed and I wandered, and often I pondered the fate of the family and friends left behind. What happened to Mary, my good buddy Larry? They never were far from the back of my mind. And as the years passed in my search for a song, what pulled at my heart all along was a call to the homeland, my wide open homeland, and sharing a meal with my own kin and kind. My heart, it was gladdened, but my mind, it was saddened to think of the years I had spent on the road. I missed the blue mountains, the white foamy fountains that fall to the sea from the hillside above. And those that would tell me I shouldn't return don't know all the lessons I learned. The bald eagle soaring, the waterfall roaring, it's great to be back in the land that I love. The bald eagle soaring, the waterfall roaring, it's great to be home in the land that I love.
Dan Saba, and I don't know if you can read out there in the dark, but this is particularly one of my favorite descriptions in the book tonight. A couple of songs I wrote, and maybe one I borrowed, strange songs for puzzled people. Well, I intend to be listening. Dan told me that he will be at Humpy's tomorrow night with the downtown Slicker Pickers after the festival ends, which is right around 10 or 11 or so. And I think he's almost set here. Except he doesn't have a vocal line. Dan Saba.
Sung through a booty before. I think it does something to the high end. There's a real high feel to the, there's no vocal amount. There it is. Well, part of the strange songs for weird people, I guess, or whatever it is that you never know what the sound's gonna be like. I never know what you're gonna hear. So I'm gonna start off with my little set here with a couple songs. I'm gonna do mostly songs I wrote, and maybe you can pick the one that I stole. This first one is about getting away from Anchorage, getting out to the big bad city, getting up to where the air is clean and everything is happy and healthy. This is called Up Alone on a Mountain. The monitor's real hot. That's nice. Every summer I feel it, when life gets unreal it seems nothing can heal it but to go for a hike. So I pull my old boots on, start singing a trail song, tell the world I'll be gone as long as I like. Leaving the flats behind is where I find peace of mind. Alone and above, I find rest and release. Up where the air is clear, feels like my God is near. I lose my earthly fear, I feel at peace. Alone on a mountain, alone on a mountain, alone on a mountain so tall. Just show me a tree line, and I'll make a beeline for the top of the mountain and away from it all. Leaving the flats behind is where I find peace of mind. Alone and above, I find rest and release. Up where the air is clear, feels like my God is near, and I lose my earthly fear, I feel at peace. alone on a mountain, alone on a mountain, alone on a mountain so tall. Just show me a tree line and I'll make a beeline, top of a mountain and away from it all. Take a nap on the tundra, take a leak on a tree, 'cause I know that there's no one there looking at me. Look out on Anchorage and a world that can't see that you're not really living if you're not really free. When I get back down, then I clean off my boots and I go back to work and I try hard to smile. It may be a Monday, but I'm dreaming of Sunday when I had a fun day just hiking in style. Alone on a mountain, alone on a mountain, alone on a mountain so tall. Just show me a tree line, and I'll make a beeline, top of a mountain and away from it all. To the top of a mountain and away from it all.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's great. I can hear myself, you can hear me. This is great to be here on the first night, second night of the festival. The sunlight loss and deprivation kind of gets to me after a while, so. There's a lot of strange things about Alaska that take place, one of which is we have darkness for 6 months of the year. And I tried to write a song here once to explain to the folks back in the flatlands of Ohio, where I come from, just about Alaska, what it is and why it's kind of strange living here. And in doing so, I tried to tell the truth, but it came out like a lie. So I called the song Alaska Lies. I tell the truth here. Well, Alaskan girls are ladylike. They all wear silk and lace. You'll never catch one out in public without powder on her face. And Alaskan guys, we're gentlemen. We all wear suits and ties, 'cause appearance is important here, and other kinds of lies. Well, the living is inexpensive here, a home don't cost a lot, and the electric company's glad to make it cheap to keep home hot. And all those fruits and vegetables, they fly up on the friendly skies. They pass the savings on to us and other kinds of life. Well, the weather's real predictable up here. You know, it never rains a lot. And it's only cold in the winter time, and every summer's hot. And in South Central Alaska, we're famous for clear skies. You'll never need a raincoat here and other kinds of pie. Well, there's silver on South Franklin Street, and two streets all gone dry. No one drinks on 4th Avenue, and no one in Homer's High. No altered states of consciousness will ever glaze our eyes. Hey, we never touch a drop of beer, another has lies. Well, the Oilers love the Greenies, and the Greenies love them back. And oil spills just an accident, they cleaned up just like that. We don't let no pollution in our oceans or our skies. We're all environmentalists up here and other kinds of lies. It gets political now. Well, our legislators, they work so hard from session start to end. You'll never catch those public servants doing favors for their friends. Republicans and Democrats will always compromise, 'cause they don't even care about re-election and other kinds of lies. Here's a brand new one. Well, Tony Knowles is governor, and everybody's pleased. He won it by a landslide, he took just the votes he needs. And he's far away from Anchorage, it'll be no surprise that there's a coastal trail to Juneau. And rubber. In bed with one of those wonderful Alaska viruses might relate to this song, which is a song I wrote about what might happen if one of those little critters got hold of you and never let go. This is called, well, you'll know what it's called here. Here's an ordinary story of an average guy who liked to take walks in the rain. Until one day, a virus snuck into his sinus and his poor life was never the same. He woke up next morning, his nose was stuffed up, and his joints felt all achy and dull. Although he couldn't see, it was his fate to be the man with the world's longest cold. He tried contact to Dristan and Sudafed too, decongestants and drugs of all sort. He ate vitamin C by the fistful and drank Vicks 44 by the quart. He prayed for deliverance, he cried for a cure, but the doctors had nothing to say. His eyeballs were swollen, his nose was so sore, and he cooked up 4 gallons a day. There's all kinds of cooties, every mankind, 9,000,000,050 all told. But the worst one of those is stuck up the nose of the man with the world's longest cold. Well, the talk shows competed to get him on camera. Arsenio, Whoopi, and Jay. Geraldo asked his ex if he sneezed during sex, and Oprah asked how he'd lost weight. They had him on down to the old Pentagon, and they pinned on a medal or two. All the army had learned from studying his germs was the least that his country could do. Well, there's all kinds of hassles to hassle mankind, like the plagues and the poxes of old. But there's nothing of late that compares with the fate of the man with the world's longest cold. Sad here. Well, his life was sure to go out. Instrumental. Here we go. Well, as years came and went, he tried hard to accept the sticky hand that fortune had dealt. Yes, he dribbled and he drained, but he never complained, although bad was as good as he felt. His life was sure tough, and when he'd had enough, he took a Kleenex and crawled to his bed. With a final adieu and a fatal achoo, he blew his brains out of his head. Now you may think your life has got troubles, but if only the truth could be told, a world full of snot, just be glad that you're not the man with the world's longest cold. Well, part of the reason for liking the state is the, as I said before, the strange things that happen. And one of the strangest that has ever happened to me was one day when I was sitting up, answering a call of nature about 2 o'clock one morning, and suddenly the earth started moving and shaking and racking and rolling, and I didn't know what was going on, and I thought I had something to do with it. It was an earthquake. So here's a song that's actually going to be recorded and sent over for the Japanese market any day now. It's called Earthquake. I was minding my own business, just sitting on the throne, when I felt a sort of rumbling that I knew was not my home. I put down my Reader's Digest and I pulled up on the jeans. My chandelier was swaying and it was worse than it first seems. It was an earthquake.
Earthquake, Mother Nature's mad again, and it felt like an 11 on a Richter scale of 10. Earthquake, earthquake, let's head for higher ground. When that tidal wave arrives, I just don't want to be in town. You see, it happens here in Alaska, oh, every month or so. No way you can predict it, but when it comes, you'll know. You'll wonder if you're crazy or if it's Judgment Day, but then you just hold on and hope like hell it goes away. Cause it's an earthquake, earthquake, the ground has lost control. Like Bill Haley and the comets, you just rattle, shake, and roll. Earthquake, earthquake, it scares you and then it's gone. You're left to dry your underwear and write these stupid songs. Well, you're snuggling with your sweetheart. She's finally given in. She loves you for your body and don't care if it's a sin. You're going hot and heavy. She's almost to the top. She says the earth is moving and then it does, and so you stop. It's an earthquake. Oh, well, you might as well get dressed and find out where to tune, cause this is really not a test. Forget the bottled water, cause I'm looking for some gin. There's gonna be an aftershock, the only question's when. That's okay, there's a moral. Good people, heed my warning, and don't ever turn your back on dear old Mother Nature, cause she just might attack. Remember on Good Friday back in 1964, she left a few alive and now she's coming back for more. It's an earthquake, earthquake, the ground has lost control. Like Bill Haley and the comets, you just rattle, shake, and roll. Earthquake, earthquake, it scares you, then it's gone. You're left to dry your underwear and write these stupid songs.
Songs for puzzled people. The next lady that is coming on stage is I go back a long way with. When I first started playing solo guitar and voice in town here, it was 20 something years ago. And I used to play at a place called the Bread Factory. You guys remember that? Every once in a while, this lovely lady with long, sort of reddish blonde hair would stroll in and teach me a song. And I have cherished those songs all these years. And I asked her what she wanted me to say about her, and she said, I'll just tell them I play sometimes, and sometimes I don't. But we're glad she's back. She is going to be playing some of the folk festival things around town. I think I wrote it down here somewhere. Café Jolie on Thursday, Cyrano's on Wednesday, she can't remember where on Monday, but she's going to look it up. And Ellen Lockyer. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. I'm sure I'll remember. It's either Café Jolie or Cheers. Okay, I'm going to start with an old blues song called Blues in the Night. Tell me if it's too loud. Now the rain is falling, hear that? double UC Handy song. Here's one I learned off of a Judy Hensky album. She was a singer I admired when I was in college. I don't know whatever became of her. This is called High Flying Bird. Slippery guitar strap. To wear your sunglasses. See those people in the first row? This is called Talking About My Honey. Slippery guitar, though. I polished it. That was a mistake.
When I'm down and feeling blue,
This is all the songs I have on my list have the word baby in them. A baby. Nobody ever writes songs like, "If you come back, baby, bring the rent." Or, "Stay away, baby." But I think I could probably do a good job. This is a song called "Walking My Baby Back Home." Johnny Ray used to sing it when I was a little kid. And I always loved it. It goes like this. Because you have to put yourself in another time, you know, when people walked. They actually walked. They walked from the house to the movie theater, or they walked from the house to the grocery store. Nobody walks anymore, so this brings us back to a happier time. Well, gee, but it's great after being out late, walking my baby back home. Well, on and on, over meadow and pond, walking my baby back home. Well, we stroll along, harmonizing a song, or I'm reciting a poem. Well, owls fly by and they give us the eye, walking my baby back home. Well, we stop for a while, I give him a smile, I cuddle my cheek to his chest. We start into bed, and that's when I get my powder all over his vest. Well, after I sort of straighten his tie, well, he wants to borrow my comb. One kiss and then it's a pleasure again, I'm walking my baby back home. Give you all the songs I wrote. I don't know who the timer is. I hope I got. Do I have time? Yeah. Heck, I did not time my set. That's a punishment. An offense punishable by I don't know what. But usually they just drag you away after 15 minutes. This is a song called "Graveyard Blues." I do a lot of blues stuff, and for reasons I'll never understand, most blues songs are about sort of depression and despair. I mean, I think all those people have alcohol problems and a lot of unresolved conflicts, you know, stemming from their dysfunctional upbringings, but what the heck? I'm not really like this, but it's a good song, though. I wrote it at the Juno Folk Festival years ago when I was really into traveling around the state, you know, playing in bars and stuff. It's real basic, gotta do a lot of bass here. Hang on. Thank you. quickie and then I'm out of here. This is a song I learned when I lived in Vermont for quite a long time. And there's some good music happening there. This is a song written in the 20s by Agnew and Yellen. Shows these things haven't changed much. This is a tune called Mama Goes Where Papa Goes. Or Daddy Don't Go Out Tonight. Oh, I know. I'll let her fiddle with these gadgets here. My own. I'm not a. This is a. Okay. Hey, look out, y'all, Henry Lee, said of Mrs. Lucy Brown. How come you disappear when the sun goes down? You eat my meat, you drink my chicken soup, and then you fly the coop. Well, your mama got a feeling she best go along to see her. Loving papa keep his willpower strong. Cause mama goes where papa goes. Oh, daddy don't go out tonight. I said your mama goes because your mama knows that you can't be trusted. Well, out of her sight, well, you think that you're the hottest lover in this town. Well, your mama knows just how to turn you down for down. So mama goes where papa goes. Oh, daddy don't go out tonight. Slippers and your evening clothes, your hat and your gloves, you know I paid for those. You can go out and step, but listen, daddy dear, there ain't one thing out there you can't get in here. Now your mama got a feeling she suspects that friend you're going to meet is of the female sex. So mama goes where papa goes. Oh, daddy don't go out tonight. Well, I say to your mama goes because your mama out of her sight. Well, you think that you're the hottest lover in this town. Well, your mama knows just how to turn it down for down. So mama goes where papa goes. Oh, daddy don't go out tonight. I do-ba-ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-be-dee-dum. Well, there's plenty of daddies and you ain't the worst, but your mama here believes in safety first. And well, admit I'm right, one husband in the home is worth 100 out of sight. Now your mama got a feeling she best be near to see her loving daddy keeps his conscience clear. So mama goes where papa goes. Oh, daddy don't go out tonight. Well, I say to your mama goes because your mama knows you can't be trusted. Out of her sight, well, the teacher used to tell me when I was in school, and a gal who trusts a man is just a dog.
Found on the stairs, Evan Michael Phillips, and oh, he's so cute. If you don't come up pretty soon, I'm reading the contents. Evan, are you in here? Oh, good, I get it. Well, this next group is called Ankerstein, and it is Dave Hamray, Patty Hamray, John Michaud, Denise Martin, Jack Kerr, Mike Richardson, and They are the only band in town that claims to be the beer-drinking, foot-stomping, wild dance music-playing mutant children of Elvis Stringed Free Reed Consortium. Did I get it? Oh, among other things. Okay? I just might hang out here, you know, I can't fit in. I did. I told my one joke. Okay, I am collecting jokes, and you can pass yours to the edge of the aisle, and we'll get it down to me, and I'll read it. And you must give yourself credit for it, so make sure you sign your name. This is a Chinese song that they're doing, called Tune In. I just was told backstage I tell jokes really bad, so I'm not even trying anymore. Anchor Steam.
Thank you.
All right, we're all on here. Everybody check.
When are we on?
Check.
Here we go. This is not a Cajun tune.
This is a Flemish schottische.
It's the truth.
A Skepper schottische. But we call it Mike's Cajun tune because we don't know the name of it.
Thank you.
genetically enhanced mutant children of Elvis. But that was too long to fit on the album, so they shortened
it. Sound man, turn him down over there on the album.
I'll fire you if you do. Okay, what are we doing next? I think we have a mind blank here. Oh, we got a singing tune. We're having a hard time remembering this one.
Inside joke.
Thank you. Last tune is Malagra's Steamboat. Way cool. Good for dancing, Clogger.
Okay, I'm still looking for that really cute guy whose wallet I have.
Evan Phillips. Come and get it. We have all kinds of things for sale out in the auditorium out front. This is the auditorium out in the foyer. There's t-shirts for sale, and that help. Oh, sure, sure. Yeah, he says he's delivering it. Okay. We have tapes for sale. Many of the people that you're hearing tonight or heard today or will hear tomorrow or next week have their product for sale outside, and it does make them feel better. I speak from experience. Whoa, we got more jokes coming in. I have some helpers out here. We are having a raffle as well. I think you get to go to Seattle. Oh, can't wait. For $5 for a ticket or 5 tickets for $20, you can win a trip to Seattle. Is it a trip for one or two, kids? Trip for two. So about buy those tickets. There's only going to be 1,000 tickets sold, so it's a pretty good chance that you win. Okay. I got some jokes here. You guys have been very generous. Three guys walked into a bar. The fourth one ducked. Okay. Thank you for sharing. Oh, I'm sorry, Denise. I can't do this one. Until some of the kids leave. All right, we have another one here. Why does a seagull live by the sea?
I don't know, why?
Why is she here? Because if they lived by the bay, they'd be bagels. Hey, it's not a paid gig, all right? Chugach Mountain Range Cloggers.
Thank you.
that was John Eric. We don't have much time here between songs. Could you get that tape rewind okay? A little bit. Our next song is Boots, Scootin' Boogie.
Thank you. anybody that's interested in learning how to clog can see Betty McIntyre, who's sitting out in the audience. She's our secretary. She's got some sore feet. Betty, stand up, wave, take your clothes off or something, so anybody can see where you're at. I don't know where you're at. Right in front here. Wave your hands, Betty. Okay, right in front here. So, anybody that's interested in some information, see you Betty. Our next song, Rocky Top.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are the Chugach Mountain Clog.